feet. Even mucks about with those who cannot fleet. Keep it in mind, he's one of a kind. Oh, life's a treat with Shaun the Sheep. He's Shaun the Sheep.
He's Shaun the Sheep.
He's Shaun the Sheep.
He's Shaun the Sheep.
He doesn't miss a trick or ever lose a beat.
Lose a beat.
Perhaps one day you'll find a way to come and meet with Shaun the Sheep. Oh, come and meet with Shaun the Sheep.
Greetings everybody, it's Laborock Strikes Back once again, and hope you guys are having a good day so far. My day has been okay so far. Just finished work, and here, and as you can see, the train is now passing by, and now I'm officially back, I'm outside filming to make this with you. Reason why I'm filming outside, because my family's home, and I have no choice to stay in that, stay in the same location when I film my off-topic stuff series, so yeah. But hey, it's better than nothing, at least I get to do a review today. So, today I'm going to review on Shaun the Sheep. Came out in 2007, the same year as The Simpsons Movie, Ratatouille, the god-awful Spider-Man 3, the god-awful Shrek the Third, which that film was garbage, Surf's Up, Alvin and the Chipmunks, the live action, the first film, the live action one, Back at the Barnyard, Chowder, what else... Phineas and Ferb, etc. So I'm not explaining the plot is, I'm just gonna leave it as it is. Now, Shaun the Sheep was first found in the one of the Warner Sir Gromit short, A Close Shave. And actually, Shaun actually made his first appearance in that one. And of course, that short was a hit, of course, it's Warner Sir Gromit because it's very popular in my country. As you can see, I'm a British YouTuber. It did really well that Shaun the Sheep actually managed to get his own series, and when it first came out, it was a massive box of it was a massive hit. It aired on CBBC, which apparently they aired offer in that in my country on that channel, along with this series and Boy and Girl Cat Mouse and Cheese, which I also reviewed that show a few months ago. So now, keep in mind, guys, I haven't seen Shaun the Sheep in years. The last time I watched the show was back in 2013. I was just watching random episodes. I don't remember watching every episode. I have watched a great amount of episodes during my lifetime, but I did watch the show growing up, and I have seen the movie back in 2018 on Netflix. And so I will talk about those two films later in the review. Now, granted, I'm not gonna mention most of the episodes in this one because I haven't seen the show for years. But that's not what I wanted to say, guys. So, what I think of Shaun the Sheep, it's an absolute classic. It's a great show, and definitely Aardman's great work next to Wallace and Gromit. And yes, I do like Aardman. I think Aardman's a great company. They bought us chicken, they made Chicken Run, Wallace and Gromit, and of course their movie Wallace and Gromit Curse of Rare Rabbit, which is a masterpiece. That film was amazing. It was amazing to bring a masterpiece. I'm surprised myself. That's one of the DreamWorks movies and Aardman films I have never reviewed on my channel. I have seen the movie, but I have never reviewed Wallace and Gromit, The Curse of the Rare Rabbit. I've never got around to review it because people requested to do it during Halloween month. As it, you know, I decided not to do it because at the time I stopped taking requests during that time in 2022. So yeah. So anyway, let's get into the animation and the stop motion. The animation and stop motion of this series is absolutely great. It still holds up to this day, because Aardman knows how to make great shows and great movies in general. Oh yes, they make Pirates of the Caribbean, they made the Pirates in Adventures of Scientists, that came out in 2012, which is another film I have seen but I never reviewed on my channel. I do need to review more Aardman movies on my channel to keep my channel going. I never reviewed Chicken. Hey, shut up, I'm trying to make a video! Sorry guys, this is a horn. Hey, shut up, trying to make a video! Sorry guys, this is a fuck, it's just the, sorry. Sorry guys, this is a train. Back I was saying, guys, So yeah, those are what I will consider reviewing on my channel. So let's get into the character himself. Let's get into the character Shaun, the main character of the series. He's actually my favorite character in the series, and honestly, Shaun's a great character. I really like him. Yes, it's a silent cartoon, it's a silent series, just like Tom and Jerry, and Oggy and the Cockroaches, which is a good series, and it's also like Zeke and Sharko, which is another great show that me and Jeremy did watch together back in November. We binge watching the a lot of episodes during that time when my family went to Portugal at the time. So yeah, I mean, the way how they did it in this series is absolutely clever. So yeah, Shaun's a great character, and we have Timmy, which is over there, not Timmy from South Park or Very Odd Parents. This Timmy over there, he's a cute character. I do like him. Now, this ain't a joke, guys. I've never seen Timmy Time. Granted, I am aware of the series exists. The back growing up, during 2008 when it first premiered. This is at the time I grow out of Nick Jr. and CBBC, and CBC. This is the time I actually grow out of these channels, and I moved on. I don't even hate those channels back then. I just grow out of them, because we all grow out of those series back in the day. But they still have a special place in my heart. But I grow out of those channels back in 2008, and I focus on watching. And instead, I'll be watching a bit of Nickelodeon and Jetix and Dizzy XD and the good old Dizzy Channel, which I love. Dizzy Channel, which rest in peace, Dizzy Channel, Dizzy XD in my country. And sadly, it's not in Sky anymore. Moment silent, guys. No, okay, guys. So yes, I've never seen Timmy Time. I know my YouTube friend Jeremy. I've watched that show growing up. He says it's a good series, which I might consider checking out Timmy Time and see what it's like. I might consider watching some on BBC iPlayer to see what it's like. I do have BBC iPlayer in my home, like I have it on my laptop, on my phone, and TV. BBC iPlayer is for free. You can watch any shows you want, like. Like those twos I mentioned, a boy, girl, cat, mouse, and cheese. You can watch any episode you want, as long as you live in the UK or Ireland or Scotland or Wales, all that kind of stuff. So yeah. So anyway, they have Ridstar the dog, which he's a great character. I do like him. He's another great character in the Shaun the Sheep franchise. And of course, we have the owner of the household, and that is the farmer. That's right, the farmer in this series. Sorry guys, this is a notification. Back I was saying, guys. Yeah, the farmer, yes, right, he's played by John Sparkles, that's right. The narrator guy from Peppa Pig. Yes. AKA the one I used to say, shut up, narrator guy! Shut up, narrator guy, in my Peppa Pig Unrated series. Anybody remember that? I used to do that every time he speaks. I said to the narrator guy to shut up in most of my Peppa Pig Unrated videos. I'm sorry I bring this up, guys. It's just I'm bringing it back for memories, guys. I hope you enjoy that memory nostalgia I want to bring up, because just for comedy purpose, guys. And yes, now look, guys, I don't hate John Sparkles in general. I think he's a great actor. He is a very good actor in general, and I will admit his imagine the narrator guy and Mr. Potato from that series is his worst performance he has done in his career, but he's a very good actor. I think he's a great actor. He sounds like a really nice guy and a really nice person in real life. And but I have to say, him as the farmer is easily his best performance he's ever done in his career. And like, he was such a great character. So yes, I don't remember most of the episodes. I haven't seen the series for years. I mean, I do have a favorite episode, and that was that pizza episode. I did watch that pizza episode a few days ago, and I thought it was a pretty good episode. That was actually a really entertaining episode. I really enjoyed the pizza episode. That was actually great. So, and this series is very popular in my country. It has some DVDs, has some merchandise, has some t-shirts. It's quite a popular series in my country. And of course, I can't forget to talk about the movies, guys. And yes, due to Shaun the Sheep's popularity, that Shaun has got his own movie, and that is the Shaun the Sheep movie, which came out in 2014 in my country, and in 2015 in the US and Canada, etc. Now, this movie I have seen, but I've never reviewed it on my channel. I did do it as my "What do you think of this movie?" back in my early years on my channel in 2019. I actually did say this is a great film. I did watch this movie on Netflix back in 2018, so, and it was a great film. It was a very good film. I'm actually might consider rewatching the film and do a potential review on my channel. So yeah, and funny enough, guys, I didn't know that there's gonna be a Shaun the Sheep movie until I went to go see How to Train Your Dragon 2. That's right. I didn't know that Shaun the Sheep got a movie until I went to go see How to Train Your Dragon 2 in cinemas. And yes, I actually went to an early screen to see that film back in 2014. And that's actually my favorite out of the three films. And even got a sequel called Shaun the Sheep Movie Farmageddon. Now, I'm actually going to say this on camera, guys, but I've never seen a Shaun the Sheep movie Farmageddon. That's why I've never seen Shaun the Sheep Farmageddon. Now, yeah, guys, this is a film I was 5 years late. This film came out the same year as Casagrande's Blue's Clues and You, Amphibia, and Tete Pikachu, Toy Story 4. Now, I have seen the trailer for this movie a few times in the cinema. I think I got the trailer for this. I did get the trailer for this movie when I went to go see Toy Story 4, and I think I got the trailer for this movie when I went to go see the Angry Birds movie too. This is back then. I used to see films at Showcase Cinema, which I don't go to that cinema. I don't go to Showcase Cinema anymore due to the fact that me and my family moved to a new home back in 2021. So I may have mentioned that in my Toy Story 4 review, even though I might consider, I think I may have mentioned that. I need to rewatch that video anyway, so yeah, I've never seen this movie. I have seen this movie doesn't cost, that's not that expensive at HMV, so I might get a copy of it at HMV. I might do a potential review and along the first film, because I do want to review more Aardman movies on my channel. I mean, the only Aardman movie I review on my channel was Flushed Away. I need to review more on my channel along with Chicken Run. And speaking of Chicken Run, I've never seen the sequel on Netflix back in last year. That's right, I've never seen the sequel that came out last year on Netflix, which I was originally gonna review that last year during December, but due to the fact I was so busy doing Christmas Buff during that time, my reviews on those is actually on a hold. So I might message on Google Chat to Jeremy, say should I do a review on both Shaun the Sheep movies to keep my channel going. So yeah, I might consider getting both films on DVD at some point. So yeah, and I really do hope I do a complete series on this series. So overall, guys, Shaun the Sheep is a classic. It's an absolute masterpiece, and this really puts CBB on the map, because I gotta say, so yeah, if you haven't seen the series yet, I highly recommend it. The series is great, and sorry guys in the background, so back out saying guys. So overall, this show gets a 10 out of 10. It's an amazing, brilliant masterpiece. So that's my review on Shaun the Sheep. Now, just to let you know, there won't be any reviews tomorrow because I'm off from work on that day. And also there won't be any reviews on Monday as well because there was no reviews. So I don't know yet. I haven't got my shift rotor yet, so yeah. So hope you enjoy my review on Shaun the Sheep. I'll keep you guys updated what my next review is going to be, because I have been doing a lot of reviews on my channel recently to keep my channel going. Now I haven't, so just to let you know, like I said, my Primo's rant is going to be delayed. I'm going to wait till the next couple episodes air on the Disney Channel in US and Canada, because I do want to rant on Primo's, but it hasn't come to Disney Plus in my country just yet. So I know Gwen the Cat refused to watch Primo's, but I'm still going to need to watch it anyway, so I can do a rant on it. And yes, it got a 5.2 on IMDb, which I knew that's going to happen. So anyway, hope you guys had a good day. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel, like and share to your friends. Until next time, goodbye.